Thanks, guys. So sunny day, no wind, but Site Shield, come on up, and Data Bacon is next.
The National Weather Service in Raleigh has issued a tornado warning for Wake County. Is that here? Is that Fuquay? Is it Zebulon? Is it something I need to worry about? I don't know, but this will answer the question. Let's see the first line. This is my church. This is Huntsville, Alabama. November 15th, 1989. The tornado came through at 4:30 in the afternoon, so this was taken the next day when the sun had come up. It's my church. That's my brother's school. Tornadoes do this kind of stuff. And when you have a tornado warning, you need to take cover, because this is what happens when tornadoes come through sometimes. Not as big a deal here, which is why I'm showing you these slides. But it's still a big deal, and this could happen here. This is a tornado warning. So we have the problem of getting this tornado warning, which follows not political boundaries, but whatever the weather does. Mother Nature pays little notice to our political boundaries. And so when they draw the warnings, they issue this, but they cover corners of counties and they cover other stuff. So that's part of the problem. People have to know what the warned area is at that moment when the warning is issued. Gone. It leads to this confusion. Is it in my area or is it not? This confusion leads to people sheltering when they don't need to, or people not sheltering when they should, or taking extra time to shelter when they should be getting in the shelter right away. But this is the solution. This is a Raspberry Pi with a weather radio receiver board on top. It can combine inputs from both the weather radio, go on to the next slide. The weather radio transmissions from the Weather Service, which contains only county level data, with the information from the internet, which contains also the polygon that describes the exact warned area. Install the weather radio in a specific location, and you can tell whether it is inside or outside that polygon, and alert only when it is inside that polygon. All right, so let's look at these polygons. Back up. Look at these polygons. You can see, if you're in the warned area over there, then you need to know right away that you're inside the warned area. If you're not in the warned area, you don't need to hear anything about this storm. And this is particularly true in offices, gymnasiums, where people are exercising or whatever else. You don't want to interrupt the business during a tornado somewhere else. And you do want to shelter if there's a tornado where you are. So you do that. Now, if you're in, say, this part of the county, you want to be able to continue your business because the storm has gone on by. This will take care of that. Go on. So who needs to do this? So the customers are going to be big box stores, big offices, schools, daycares, DOD, USPS, alarm companies. Now this brings us to the unique value proposition and the competitors. There are no competitors for this. The alarm companies are not interested in this. These are the people, the alarm companies will charge you $12 to check a pole station on the fire alarm. And they charge you that kind of thing for all the different things in your whole system. And they're going to charge you $10,000, $20,000 to go check out annually the fire alarm at Red Hat. Okay, fine. And then we're going to want to install this kind of thing on top of that. So this is where the pricing ideas come from and things like that. Then the unique value, of course, is that we provide this site-specific sheltering instructions at the time of need exactly. And not any other time. So we don't disrupt except when there's a need for warning. All right, this is our customer map. This also happens to be a map of tornado wind speeds and that kind of thing on average. The red zone is where we expect to do the most sales. People in the red zone know this problem well. People in the orange zone, that's a marketing opportunity, an educational opportunity. We need to explain that it's a thing you need to cover. Next page. Open data. National Weather Service issues this data. This is open data. And we have several channels for that. Next slide. This is a business plan. We come back to this. Next slide. Market potential. $148 million annual market that we're looking at.
that we would like to tap some of. And the next one. We've got some needs. We need some funding for this. We need some early adopters. We need some engineering support. We could use some marketing help. So that's where we are. I'll entertain your question. Yes, this could be useful for earthquakes, early warning for earthquakes. It could be useful for flooding, install it at Crabtree Valley Mall and tell people to move their cars as soon as it starts raining. that kind of thing. So it could be useful for other particular hazards. Tornado warnings are the ones that I have personally paid the most attention to. Another weather hazard is a severe thunderstorm with winds over 70 miles an hour. Same rules for tornado shelter. So easy enough to program that in. But earthquakes are a real possibility for designing this in and making a site-specific system.
One question I have as a local government employee is, I would assume there would need to be some sort of policies for this. Just thinking of potential liability,
right,
or if it goes wrong or anything like that. And that would take a lot of time to come to pass. So where do you envision that and how that, handling that?
As a company that would provide this service, there's a liability aspect to it. Do we have a false alarm? Do we fail to deliver an alarm that needs to be delivered? We would work out something with the lawyers to say the liability is balanced between what we can accept and what they can accept. And so we would say limit it to 2 or 3 years worth of subscription for that one failure. But we test the wazoo out of it so that we know that the software is really reliable. And as for a process, yes, every site should have sheltering process in place. This would be the notification tool. And this would expedite the notification and make it specific to when the storm is in that particular location.
Do you envision, or have you given thought to potentially building out for infrastructure disruption, bridges giving way, roads giving way? Is this model conducive to building out for such matters?
I don't think it's going to help when the infrastructure falters. If the internet fails, it's going to be able to still deliver a warning because it can see. It can receive the message over the radio. It'll receive the message on the radio. It'll receive the county-specific warning. Even when the internet fails, it will know the internet has failed, and then it will sound the alert. It'll have a battery backup to keep it running, provided that the internet is still running. So those things they will have to think of. As far as other infrastructure pieces.